So the Sheikh says here, اعلم رحمك الله أنه يجب على كل مسلم ومسلمة تعلم هذه المسائل الثلاث والعمل بهن. So the Sheikh says, know, may Allah have mercy upon you, that it is obligatory upon every Muslim, male and female, to learn about these three issues and to act upon them. So the Sheikh says the first one is al-ula anna Allah khalaqana wa razaqana wa lam yatrukna hamala bal arsala ilayna rasula faman ata'ahu dakhala al-jannah wa man 'asahu dakhala an-nar. So the Sheikh says the first is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, He sustains us and provides for us. He did not neglect us and leave us without any direction. Rather, He sent us a messenger. Whoever obeys Him enters paradise, and whoever disobeys Him enters hellfire. And the Shaykh will also give us the evidences for this, or the evidence for this. And the Shaykh says, وَالدَّلِيلُ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, and the evidence for this, because the Shaykh has made something wajib, and then he will back it up with evidence to prove that it is wajib and obligatory. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ رَسُولًا شَاهِدًا عَلَيْكُمْ كَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَى فِرْعَوْنَ رَسُولًا فَعَصَى فِرْعَوْنُ الرَّسُولَ فَأَخَذْنَاهُ أَخْذًا وَبِيلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, verily we have sent to you a messenger who is a witness upon you, like we've sent a messenger to Pharaoh. Fir'aun disobeyed. Fir'aun disobeyed the messenger and we punished him severely. So the Shaykh has made an introduction and he said that أَنَّ اللَّهَ خَلَقَنَا, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, and that is quite clear. It doesn't need a lot of evidence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, I have not created male, the man, jinn and mankind except to worship me. So there's many evidences, many ayahs in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the people that He is their creator. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هَلْ مِنْ خَالِقٍ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ, is there any other creator other than Allah? No, there isn't. That's the reply. وَرَزَقَنَا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided for us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا, there is not any creature that walks on the face of this earth except that Allah will provide for it. So the rizq is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Razaqul Mateen. He is the one who provides and is the best of the Raziqeen, those who provide. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best. وَلَمْ يَتْرُكْنَا هَمَلًا, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not neglect us to find the truth through trial and error. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us guidance. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ, do you think we created you out of play, or you know, for joy, and that you not come back to us? So meaning you will be questioned about everything that you did. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent us a messenger, and that is also mentioned in many ayats in the Quran, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent a messenger. There is not even a nation that have not received the message through these messengers. So the Shaykh gives us further evidence for that anyway. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that He sent us a messenger. Inna arsalna ilaykum, we have sent you a messenger. So even Fir'aun received messenger, and all the other people, nations received the message through these messengers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent us a messenger as well. So whoever obeys the messenger enters paradise. And this is mentioned in a hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Man ata'ani dakhala al-jannah wa man asani faqad aba. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in a hadith, Kullu ummati yadkhuluna al-jannata illa man aba. All of my ummah is entering paradise except those who refuse. And the companion said, Ya Rasulullah, who is going to refuse? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, whoever follows me will and obeys me will enter paradise. Whoever doesn't follow me has refused, meaning has refused to enter paradise. So the Shaykh has given us this ayah as evidence. And this talks about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent a messenger to us and also to Fir'aun, and the consequence of Fir'aun disobeying and disbelieving and becoming rebellious towards the Prophet that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him, which was Musa. The outcome was that he was punished severely. So there's no difference between people, whether it's Fir'aun or whether it's Haman or anybody. If they don't follow the messenger, they will end up in hellfire. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in this verse.